Georgie Stone is a confident, talented 19-year-old. But for years, she's had to fight just to be herself.
When I was looking at the other kids and everything seemed to kind of match up for them, it was confusing why it was all okay for them but it wasn't for me.
Unlike twin brother Harry, Georgie never felt comfortable and identified as female from as early as she can remember.
What moment did you start feeling and identifying and thinking, I'm a girl?
Actually, when I look back, I realise that I've always been a girl. It wasn't just because I loved the Disney princesses and gravitated towards female characters. I felt inside me, intrinsically, that I was female.
When Georgie was 2.5, she told her mum, Rebecca, she wanted to be a girl.
It was, that's a curious thing to say. And I sort of reinforced that you're a beautiful little boy, darling, you know. But the fact that she kept telling us, kept insisting, and that insistence only grew over time.
At home, Georgie was free to explore her identity, but all that changed when she started school.
School is a very gendered place. There were male toilets and female toilets, male uniform and female uniform. In sport, we were split into male and female. So from the beginning of school, I realised, oh, OK, this... I don't feel as safe as I did before.
How difficult is it when you were not allowed to go to the female bathrooms, for example? What does that do to you at that age?
It really instilled in me a sense of shame, that who I was not okay. Swimming lessons weren't fun for me in childhood. I was made to use the male change room and went straight for a cubicle. And I heard all this shouting, like, what's a girl doing in the male change rooms? And it was just horrible, humiliating, traumatizing. It was one of those core memories that has really shaped who I am. And it has taken a long time to actually work through it.
When Georgie was 7, she was diagnosed with gender dysphoria. She was only the 3rd child to be treated for the condition at Melbourne's Royal Children's Hospital.
People didn't know what to do. The school didn't know what to do. And at that point in time, there was no government schools policy for trans and gender diverse children. There were no support groups. Pretty much the only thing I would see on television about trans people was negative. It fed into all of my fears.
Around 45,000 Aussie kids are thought to identify as transgender, but access to treatment has long been a challenge. Rebecca and Georgie were forced to fight for medication in the family court, not once, but twice.
Why was it so important for you to stop puberty and make sure that you were controlling that to fit who you are?
If my body had developed in a masculine way, I would have wanted to kill myself. I knew that having to go into male puberty would have done significant harm to my mental state.
We were having to go to a stranger who wasn't experienced in medicine or gender medicine specifically, to make a decision, a life-changing decision for our child. To have that decision removed from you as a parent is the very definition of powerlessness.
Determined to change the system, Rebecca took on the courts and won, stripping it of its power to make medical decisions on behalf of transgender kids. Now they only need the permission of their parents and doctor to access hormone therapies.
What about people that would say that that is a process that needs to be included?
It's already an incredibly rigorous process and a meticulous process over many years and with lots of team members. It's not just one doctor ticking a box and saying, righto, off we go.
With the court battles behind her, Georgie flourished, becoming a passionate advocate for the trans community. Next week, she'll make her debut on Neighbours as the show's first transgender character.
Girls, this is Mackenzie. She's just moved here from New South Wales.
It would have been so wonderful as a kid to see a trans character on a show like Neighbours. That representation is so important.
But shaking the stigma isn't easy, and the transgender community continues to be a target.
The narrative that's coming from some quarters of our leadership is very harmful. We shouldn't be making kids feel ashamed of themselves.
What would you like to say to our Prime Minister, Scott Morrison?
It's important that you talk to trans young people. There's a great opportunity for all of us to really talk in a respectful way, and it'd be great to have you as an ally. We'd love to have you as an ally.
Isn't she just remarkable? It's really hard when we have to edit a package down to 3 minutes, but I've spent 2 hours with Georgie and her mum, and you can't really understand what she's gone through and the barriers that she's broken. And she's just the most resilient, remarkable young woman. And to hear some of those stories, all I had in my head when I was talking to Georgie and her mum was our Prime Minister saying, let's just let kids be kids. And when you listen to Georgie's story, well, her being allowed to be a kid was her being allowed to be the woman that she wanted to be. Mm. And it wasn't the kids that had the problem, Georgie said. Was often the fears of the parents that were projecting that onto the children. She said, you know what, Georgie, the kids at school were fine. They always understood where I was coming from. They were great. It was the parents' fear. Understandable, but so important to listen to her story, to learn from her story. And I'm so proud of her and so proud of Neighbours for reflecting our world.
Well, yeah, it's a win-win for Neighbours in a way. On one hand, they reflect the reality of our society, but on the other hand, they're really interesting issues, so it makes for compelling television.
Mm-hmm. And the other point I just want to make is, you know, Georgie was sort of laughing and saying to me, I think so many parents were scared that, oh, my God, my child's going to become transgender from hanging around transgender. Doesn't happen.
Not the case.
Mm. Nothing happened. No. They were just fully supportive. So.
And you're right, there's so much fear there, and it's so important to talk about it and to hear stories like this one.
Now, Georgie's mum, Rebecca, has written a book about her family's journey, and it's called About a Girl, and it hits the shelves on September 3. And keep an eye out for Georgie when she makes her Neighbours debut next Friday night.
And if you find yourself in need of help for any reason, crisis support is available through Lifeline on 13 11 14.